In this tutorial, I'm going to revisit Lightroom's AI-powered denoise and super resolution features because these tools no longer create separate enhanced DNG files. This small change has some advantages and a new user interface. There is nothing particularly complicated about this lesson, but I do need to warn you that these features are not things that you are ever going to notice in a social media-sized image. This lesson is all about maximizing image quality down to the tiniest pixel level. So let's zoom way in and let's get started. On the screen right now is an image that is full of sensor noise. If I zoom in, then you can see all of these false red and green pixels. For the past 5 years, we've been able to confront this kind of noise problem using the photo enhance denoise command. But if I try to run that command now, after installing the Lightroom Classic 14.4 update, then a new message will appear. This box is trying to tell us that AI-powered commands, like denoise, are no longer separated from our other developed module features. When I activate this command, Lightroom's amazing artificial intelligence-powered noise reduction will clean up this raw file without creating any additional copies. This improves our workflow in 3 ways. First, because we no longer need a separate enhanced file like the one on the right, we are going to save some hard drive space, and hopefully this will create less confusion. Second, now that denoise behaves like the other non-destructive develop module tools, we no longer need to get the amount that we apply right on the first try. On the last image, I left the amount slider at the default setting of 50, but on this image, that does not seem like enough noise reduction. To increase the strength of the denoise, I'm going to drag this slider up. Although it's tempting to crank the amount all the way up to 100, the results now look too smooth. To find the right setting, I like to jump from 100% down to 75, and then down to 50. My goal is to find the minimum amount of denoise that I can add to make this image clean but not too plastic looking. On this photo, 50% looks too noisy and 75% looks too smooth. So let's split the difference and let's go for something around 63%. Much better. The point that I want to make here is that there is no magic setting for this amount slider. You want to use as little denoise as possible, but each image is unique, and finding the right amount always requires experimentation. Finally, because denoise is no longer separated from all the other develop module tools, we can now synchronize our settings from image to image. Here, for example, I have 3 very similar frames. If I bring one of these into the develop module, and if I find the right amount of denoise, then I can finally synchronize this setting from image to image. This might not sound like a big deal, but it's a solid workflow improvement when you're working on a sequence of similar photographs. Before we move on to super resolution, let me remind you that Adobe's denoise only works on RAW files. If you try to use this feature on any other type of file, then you'll find that this tool is sadly disabled. This is yet another reason why RAW captures remain the file format of choice for serious photographers. Unlike denoise, which is best applied near the beginning of our image editing process, super resolution is often a late stage enhancement. Enlarging a photo usually produces blur, but super resolution can intelligently enlarge photos while maintaining clean edges and preserving important details. This is a feature that you only need either for large prints or after you have substantially cropped your original image. To demo, I'm going to take this image and I'm going to crop it around one of the bighorn sheep. Once I've cropped it, the resolution at this point is insufficient for printing. It's now less than 2,000 pixels on its smaller axis. But if I activate super resolution, then I get 4 times as many pixels and virtually no loss of sharpness. That's fantastic, and it raises a common workflow question. What you might have noticed is that you cannot use both super resolution and AI denoise on the same file. I can't explain why this obstacle exists for Adobe, but I can show you an easy workaround. To solve this dilemma, I'm going to apply the denoise first, since this step is best done early in the image processing pipeline. That looks much cleaner. Next, I'm going to set a tight crop around this fish. As you can see, that crop has brought the resolution of this image way down, since the denoise disabled the option to use super resolution. I need to go to the export dialog. I'm going to configure these settings so that Lightroom will make a TIFF copy. The export dialog tends to overwhelm my students, so let's talk through each of these important settings one by one. Taking it from the top, I want Lightroom to export this into the same folder as the original photo. It's super important that I also turn on the Add to This Catalog option for this type of export. Next, I could ask Lightroom to rename this file, but since I don't need to, I'm going to disable the file renaming option. We're not worrying about video here, so we can leave that one alone. But in File Settings, I need to make sure that this is in the TIFF, the TIFF file format. To keep the files a little smaller, I'll enable zip compression. I'll set the color space to ProPhoto. I'll set the bit depth to 16 bits per component. Moving down to image sizing, I'm going to turn off the resizing so that my exported copy will be just the same size as the cropped original. I can turn off output sharpening. In the metadata panel, I want it to include all of the original metadata, and if you have them, to write keywords using hierarchy. I'll make sure that the watermarking is turned off, and now I'll tap on the export button. And now I just need to find my new TIFF copy. If you're in a collection like I am, then it might not automatically pop up in front of you. No problem. All I have to do is right-click and use the Go to Folder in Library command to see this one and the new TIFF side by side. I can now take the TIFF file, select it, press the letter D to hop into the Develop module. Then I can quadruple this image's resolution using the amazing super resolution command. Bam! It took a few steps, but with this workaround, you can enjoy the benefits of both denoise and super resolution in those rare cases where you need both to really perfect your photograph. Well, there you go. These changes to denoise and super resolution are not earth-shattering, but they are a significant improvement. I hope that you found this video helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.